Here's where Cameron goes berserk.
Good afternoon, Piles, and welcome to our first day back and Happy New Year. Today is Monday, January 9th, 2023. Angelo, it's January.
I know. Only a few more months until we both graduate.
Aw, Angelo, don't say that.
I know. It sucks. It's our last season in wrestling and basketball.
Stop, Angelo, before you make me cry. Well, I'm Kimberly.
And I'm Angelo.
And this is the Pioneer Press Welcome Back Edition.
We are light on announcements today, Piles, but we've got some fun bits for you today.
To begin, happy iPhone Day. On this day, in 2007, Apple announced the iPhone to the world, with Steve Jobs announcing a technological breakthrough that would revolutionize our world.
The iPhone is considered by many to be up there with one of the greatest inventions of all time. When first announced, the iPhone was marketed as an iPhone, iPod, and internet communications device all in one.
That is insane, seeing this for the first time.
Let's play a quick game of Then and Now. In the initial press release, the word iPod appears 7 times, Apple touts the iPhone's 2-megapixel camera, and the base 4-gigabyte model price point is $499 in the US.
Fast forward to today, the iPod is dead. May you rest in peace. The iPhone 14 Pro has a 48-megapixel camera, and the base model for the iPhone 14 is $799, and boosts 126 gigabytes in storage.
To think, this was 16 years ago. Some of you were just babies.
We were just babies. Next up, Pioneers, today happens to be National Fourth Grader Day. Crazy. So in lieu of heading out to the streets, we're going to do Piles on the Streets live in studio.
We're going to need two contestants for Are You Smarter Than a Fourth Grader? Questions. Thank you. And any volunteers? River.
Oh, River. And I think we should go to Mato.
You're right. That's a great idea.
Omato.
Mr. Omato.
Fine.
Come on up.
Can I borrow that for a second? Here's the thing, guys. Here's the thing. Honestly, I think I am one of the smartest people on campus.
I don't think that.
Okay. along with a Dr. Alan Todd in the 900s, teaches math. We have, that's my coffee. Who else do we have? Dr. and Coach Joseph Aijara in the 50s. Coach Clark, he's a doctor as well. We got some smart people here, but I'm up there. I'm in that upper echelon.
Well, we'll see about that.
Yeah. And these are fourth grade questions?
Yes, they are.
Oh,
any
no.
Fourth grader would know
that. Oh,
them.
No. Oh, Sergio, you want to replace me up here?
Okay, Mr. Omedo, you have the first question.
Oh, I do. Okay.
Who was the second president of the United States?
Second president. I'm going to say John Adams.
You are... correct.
I'm going to say John Adams. Yes.
But
yes.
Do you know the third?
Oh, no. The third.
Very famous. Founding father.
The third.
He is? Oh. I don't even know who it is.
The third. I'm going to go Quincy.
Who's that?
That would be the fourth.
No.
The third is Thomas Jefferson.
Oh, wow. Yep. Wow, that... ladies and gentlemen, it's embarrassing.
All right, so River, you're for the second question. What do the 13 stripes on the U.S. flag represent?
The first 13 colonies. Wow.
The 13 original colonies, you are correct.
Wow, Mato.
See?
Wow.
Wow.
Next question.
Okay, nice job, Mato. River.
Your next question.
Making me look bad up here.
This is a math question, so make sure to pay attention here. What is 1/2 plus 1/4?
1/2. Plus 1/4. 1/2 plus 1/4. I'm gonna say a half of a fourth. An eighth.
No.
That would be incorrect.
Aren't you supposed to multiply those somewhere there?
Well, you would.
Hey, Dr. Todd, I'm sorry, man. I should be in your class right now. I'm sorry.
Dr. Todd.
1/4. Wait, say it again. 1/4.
What is 1/2 plus 1/4?
1/2 plus 1/4. Oh. 3/4.
Yes.
That was easy. I got to think in like quarters. You know?
For you math teachers, you should have got that one correct too.
I got to break it down in 25 cents.
Next question. What organ works with your heart to supply oxygen?
your lungs?
Yes, you are correct.
Oh, really? Surprised at that one.
That's an easy
one. Killing it, River.
Let me see the questions.
Show me. What is the largest organ in the body?
Largest organ in the body. I know this one.
Okay, if Amira doesn't get it, River, you have to answer.
I'm going to say... the biggest organ. time is money. We need a little countdown thing. Yeah, the largest organ. I'm going to go with... the lung.
Nope.
That would be it. That would be incorrect.
The largest organ is the skin.
Correct. Also known as the integumentary system.
That's a trick question. That's a trick question. It is an organ.
The heaviest too.
All right. Next question for River.
Yes, River. Here you go.
Blue and yellow makes what color?
Green. Good job, River.
They
set me up. They set me up.
All right, River. We know you had easy questions. Just round.
What is it, like 3-0,
so River? How about all or nothing?
All or nothing.
Would you want to take it? Okay,
yeah.
Go ahead, Mr. Romero. Right. Ready?
So this next question is River, a little bonus question.
What battle was the turning point in the Pacific Theater of World War II?
That's fourth grade.
No, that's not World War II, is it? No.
Question? What was the turning point of the Pacific Theater of World War II?
You got all yours wrong.
All or nothing.
The bombing of Pearl Harbor?
Close. Wow. Midway.
Oh, okay.
Midway.
Well, okay. Great job, guys. All right. Okay. Glad to have you here.
That finalizes our questions.
I am smarter than a fourth grader.
You are.
Not
high five. All right, thanks, guys.
All right, thank you.
Other questions.
So, Angelo, guess what?
What's up, Kim?
Season is now official.
Oh, for our winter sports.
Yes, Angelo, that's what I said.
Well, good luck to our boys wrestling, soccer, and basketball.
And good luck to our girls wrestling, soccer, basketball, and water polo. We wish you the best of luck this season. Over the break, the boys basketball team played in tournaments and started league.
The boys Froshoff and JV team started league play on Thursday with big wins over Magnolia.
The boys varsity team won on December 29th over Santa Fe High School with senior Mark Lemon hitting a game-winning three-pointer for the 1 point win and continued with a 55-38 victory over Magnolia on Thursday.
The teams play tomorrow right here in the Pow Dome hosting Santa Ana Valley High School. Go Pios!
And the wrestling team had some big wins over the break, beating Anaheim 73-6 and our girls varsity placing second at the Lady Pioneer Challenge on Saturday.
Great job, Pios.
And that's all we have for today, Pios.
Today's outro song is Hey Yeah by Outkast. This song has been awarded with BET Award for Video of the Year, Kids' Choice Award for Song for Favorite Song, and many more.
It's also a fun and upbeat song.
It sure definitely is.
And as always, Pioneers, make sure to stay connected with us on all your favorite social media platforms using @ThePowerPress.
Be sure to tag us in all your favorite photos and videos using #ThePowerPress.
If you'd like to be featured as a wayback, throwback, or flashback, reach out to us using @ThePowerPress.
As always, Pioneers, we hope you have a minty,
merrific,
mad brain,
marvelous
Monday. And we'll see you again tomorrow.
Press on, Pios.
You know what that word means?
Be quiet!
Large. Get easy. At least you mentioned World War II. That one.